told you we're in for a good show. All right. Thank you very much. I'm going to do 5 minutes of comedy, and if after 5 minutes nobody's fucking Brody Stevens, I'm leaving. Or at least just give him a hand job in your car. Just do something. Empty him off. Can you do that? It's fucking, he works hard every night, and you know what? My act is not, as my act progresses, I'm not like an act that is conducive to ladies fucking the axe, right? I mean, have you seen me before? I don't have an act that's an aphrodisiac of any kind. As my act progresses, you can hear a slight smacking sound. It's a sound of pussy slamming shut like car doors. The more I talk, it just shuts down around the room. So maybe if you were gonna fuck Brody, it's gone. I fucking ruined it. So you can hear it. Listen, faintly, like popcorn popping in an adjacent room. You can just hear it shut down. Fucking... hear it shut down like fucking the Cineplex Odeon in River Oaks. Fuck him. Just let him jack off on your tits. Well, why not? No, it's important. That's one of the big keys to life. The most important thing, you can save the whales all day and, you know, fucking recycle, but fuck someone uglier than you every now and then, because that... that's what really makes people happy. It might be base and shallow, but it's true. Nothing makes you feel better than when someone who shouldn't have fucked you did. It does. All the other bullshit goes away. All the names they call you, it doesn't matter. I can cut in front of me in traffic because that girl fucked me. Right? Someone better looking than you has fucked you at some point. You fucking the hot blonde girl up on the riser. I saw you. I sat watching Brody Stevens. And I watched him and I saw you in the background the whole time. That guy, he gets plenty of good looking pussy. Leave him and go fuck Brody. And then come back. Just say, I'm going to the toilet for 30 minutes, honey. He's not going to ask any questions. He's drinking. Well, fuck Brody and come back. You give him a fake name. You don't have to call him or anything. Just fuck him. Beautiful women like that never fucked me, and that's why I'm all cheesed off on stage. I'm a bitter comic. I'm like, I just hate comedy. Angry material. I'm not funny with the wacky sunglasses. Maybe I would have been if you were fucking me 10 years ago, but you weren't. You shunned me. You could have turned that chip on my shoulder into a warm, salty paste 10 years ago. But you chose not to. But it's all right, because you won't always be that beautiful. You just remember that. That's what makes me smile, is one day you'll be 75 years old, and you'll be trudging down Westheimer with your fucking... knee socks all peeled down over big varicose veins, and you'll have a swivel hip, fucking gym sock titties, the kind of girl you can titty fuck using just one tit. You just spin it around a few times. You have a fucking colostomy bag swinging off of you. Fucking wiggly pyorrhea teeth, a war-torn beaver, look like someone kicked a hole in the side of a rotting hog's carcass. Fucking bald spots, bed sores. Oh yeah, then you'll fuck me. Like a three-legged dog with an itchy belly. I can leave you with a disconnected phone number and a teardrop in your milky cataract eye. And until then, I have pornography to rely on. And that, you know what's fucking horribly overrated is computer porn. Internet porn is so incredibly over... like, I have videos. Why would you want to... go back to jacking off to still photography. And the fucking streaming shit is fucking horrible. By the way, I said hi to you earlier, and it was a guy that wasn't you. Where's the other fucking bald guy that I said hi to at the bar? Right there?
No,
right here.
Over here.
Okay. That's the guy I thought you were. Sorry. Now you know. So yeah, like all the fucking internet porn, and it's always like teeny porn. Ooh, hot teen, fucking barely legal, hot 18-year-old. I don't want fucking, give me hot old, like tired old 31-year-old fucking divorcee whore porn. I want to, like, I look at a picture of a teeny girl in a fucking dressed up like a cheerleader, and I know she'd say something stupid right in the middle of it. Right? Fucking, at no point during the sexual act do I want to hear anyone go, ew. Same reason I don't want to bring someone to sushi for the first time. I can't get it up for the California roll anymore. I need to fucking experiment. I want a girl who puts it in her own ass, right? Doesn't even, we're going to do something different. You know what I mean? I don't want the fucking, ew. Gross. Yeah, it is gross, but it's the only way I can come anymore. So just put on your safety goggles and fucking keep a mop handy, and for God's sakes, don't get any on your skin. You gotta pace yourself sexually. You know, you talk about trying to, you know, like keep sex interesting in a relationship, and it doesn't work. It doesn't. The only thing that keeps it, new pussy is the only thing that's consistently exciting. But other than that, like, you should try everything. Because you will. You'll try everything in a relationship. If you've been together for a while, you can only do so much. Sex is a very narrow avenue. You only have so many holes and parts. There's only so many combinations, and you'll burn out of it. Sit on me this way, and I'm going to put my hand here, and you can put your finger there. Did we do that already? Oh, then spin upside down, and now I'll put my mouth here, and you can put your hand there. Oh, did we do that too? Okay, well, why don't you dress up like this, and I'll smack you on the ass with that, and you can plug that in over there, and strap that on there, and put it here, and ow, 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 fuck. All right, my bad. I'm trying to think of something. Strangle me with a cord. We're running out of lubricant. Who's sober enough to drive? After a while, there's nothing left to do. I hope it comes full circle. I hope it comes all the way back to square one, where at some point the kinkiest thing I can think of is, I get an idea. Why don't you lay down there as awkwardly as possible? I'm going to climb on top of you. I'll be way too nervous. I'll come too quick, and you start crying. How about that? We'll wait for your parents to get home. How nice would that be, to be that easily entertained one more time? How nice would it be to be able to jack off to a National Geographic again? When you're 12 years old, that's all you needed. And one pair of flapjack titties that give you a boner for a month. Now I need gaping anus porn just to get morning piss with every now and then. That joke makes me laugh every now and then. It's not fair. If you're going to have weird sex, do it with the people you'll never see again. Don't do it to keep a fucking relationship interesting. Do it with people that... I don't mind risking being that urban legend, you know? Like the fucking guy you hear about, oh, yeah, she fucked him and she tied him up and took a dump on his chest and left or something, you know? Because there's no name attached to that story ever. Do it with the people that don't fucking know you, right? You do that shit to keep sex interesting, and then eventually that just becomes boring, and then the fucking relationship dies. You think you have someone to keep your secrets, right? You're wrapped around that girl like the dog from The Grinch That Stole Christmas. Oh, and you think you have someone to keep all your secrets? Bullshit. Your secrets are good until the day you say, maybe we should start seeing other people. And on that day, you show up at the bar and all your friends are going, hey, what's up there? Johnny likes your finger in the ass, huh? Oh, want another beer there, Mr. Pistabit, on New Year's Eve? Joni was by. She had a few things to say about you. My last girlfriend, that's how I knew I couldn't trust her, because she'd tell me horrible shit about all of her other friends, friends that I didn't give a fuck about or know. And she'd tell me, you're not going to believe this about Darren. Oh, my God. And to the point where I only knew her friends by the horrible shit she had told me about them. Like, they call on the phone. No, she's not here right now. She's out with the closet fag and the chick with the 9 abortions. You know, them. Who is this? Oh, Mr. Circle Jerk in summer camp. Yeah, I'll call you a call. As soon as you fucking break up, you find out fucking... That's two things you don't want when you just got dumped. Liquor and the code to her voicemail. That's too... That's a bad combination. I don't want to know, but I'm going to... Hi, baby. It's the new guy that's fucking you. I just want the truth in a relationship. Well, you're not getting it. I don't want the truth in a relationship. I honestly don't. No. Fucking bullshit me a bit. Right? I mean, I want the truth, but I don't want the whole truth and nothing but the truth. There's some shit. No. You went out with your ex-boyfriend, Dave, because his mom died, and you're still friends with him, and I still want him to have someone. So you went out with him, and then you didn't call that night. And the next day, I call you up, and I go, I don't want to know, but I ask, did you fuck him? And you go, no. And that's true. You didn't. But you go, oh, you know what's weird, though, is we started talking because we went out and we had a few drinks, and somehow the subject of sex came up, and we were talking about all the great sex we used to have, because we did. We had really good sex. It was incredible. And then he made the moves on me, and I said, no, because I love you, and I'm faithful to you. And then he started talking about this and that, and he drank more, and then he got really aggressive, and then I didn't know what to do because he started getting upset about his mom again, and I ended up watching him jack off in his car while he cried. I didn't know what to do. You could have stopped right out there. I didn't fuck him. That was true, and it was a lot more comfortable than it is right now. Fucking lie to me. I don't fucking like being... I got a girlfriend for a year and a half, and... I'm not going to say I'm sick of fucking her, but I'm not high-fiving my friends afterwards. So. What does it lead to? It just leads to fucking relationships or... It just leads to fucking... Marriage. Why? What kind of a idea is marriage in this fucking day and age? What? You take love, a word... Love doesn't mean anything as a word. I love... My mom, I love pancakes, I love you. And you take this vague, nebulous idea and you put it into a legal, binding contract. What? That's like signing a document promising to be lucky forever. I'm going to be lucky forever or you can sue me for half of my money. It's a bullshit fucking... Marriage? It's like the word art. It doesn't mean anything. I'm an artist. I'm a fucking drunk guy who talks dirty. Fucking artist. It's art. Well, you know, unless you're fucking drunk at a bus stop and then you're a fucking vagrant. You know, it's like the same thing. Kids, stop. We don't need kids. And if you have them, stop doing it. Stop fucking. Is there any need for children anymore? Do you have kids? Yes, I can tell by the silence. Stop it. You need a baby that bad, go to the fucking pound and get a baby. There's plenty of unwanted people, not even a baby. Go get an old man. There's unwanted people of all ages that are already pre-made and waiting for you to pick them up. Why are you going to keep lumping out fucking larvae? It's like the natural resources of this country, this world, pissed away like draft beer at a fucking frat party. And you keep practice sodomy. The government should promote sodomy, don't you think? Right beside every fucking anti-abortion billboard, there should be a pro-sodomy billboard. It's a healthy alternative. Take one in the fanny, save money on a nanny. There's something catchy. And sodomy, first of all, is sodomy is not necessarily butt fucking, so don't get all clinchy in the shorts, ladies. And sodomy technically is any type of sex that is not meant for procreation. And I know that because it's posted over my bed at the Allen Park Inn. But yeah, sure. Why is it you have kids and it comes out of my fucking check? I didn't do anything, you know? You have kids. Why do I have to pay for your fucking schools? I did nothing. I just was here. I blow a load in a girl's hair out of respect for the environment and Mother Nature. And not only do I have to pay for your kids, I gotta fucking drive past the school at 15 miles an hour on my way home to jerk off and watch The Simpsons. It's like insult to injury. Because you're not even there to protect your kids to make sure he gets across the fucking street by himself. I have to give a fucking credit card to a porn site to protect your kids. I gotta get HBO to hear a comic say fuck to protect your kids. Protect your own fucking kids. Why should I get into a taxi cab at 2:30 in the morning? Because I want to go moon sorority girls. Because I'm drunk and I have issues, but that's evident. But I can't even moon sorority girls because the taxi cab window only goes down halfway because it's a child safety window, which completely eclipses the whole hangy turkey neck part of the moon. Why even moon a sorority girl if they can't see the swingy nut part of it, which is completely cut out by the fucking... Because you had to have a kid because you don't want to mow your own lawn when you're 50. Because you didn't make goalie and win your state championship, so you want a second chance. You want to see what you'd look like if you didn't eat so much cake. That's why you don't go to the pound and get the kid. That's why you don't get the kid. So, and if it's a fucking ego trip to have your own kid, you want to see what you'd look like. That's why you don't get the fucking dirty Nicaraguan kid on the TV commercial that he really needs a fuck, huh? Get a dog, exactly. You want to fucking, you get the kid on the commercial. Well, you know why you don't? Because if you did, and he did something great, you'd only get partial credit. He hits a home run in the World Series, you're sitting in the stands going, that's my boy, kinda. Yeah, it's a fucking ego trip. Knock it off. I don't like it. My brother just had another baby. I have to fly back to Rhode Island to look at the fucking thing because I'm its uncle. Ooh. You're an uncle again. Come back and look at it. And I'm glad that he's happy. Ooh, my kids are my whole life. Well, first of all, you have to say that. You can't, even if it's bullshit, you can't go the other way on that one. It's bullshit. You fucking lie to yourself and everyone else. You can't say, oh, Timmy here? No, he ruined everything. I had hopes and dreams. I was going to travel, and I had a band, and then one drunk night without a condom. Ooh, now I work in a factory. You can see death in my eyes if you look closely. No, my kids are everything. Yeah, stick with the lie. And baby, like, I don't think babies are cute or funny. I don't want to see pictures of them. I don't have anything. My dad died, and his fucking, it took him like 2 hours to come pick up his body. And we're staring at his body, and it was pretty creepy, but he's a dead guy. And I'm thinking, that's the progression of life, right? You're born, and now you die. You're born, and you die. And then I go, well, I've only seen 2 dead bodies. This is a second dead body in 34 years. I've seen every fucking baby there is to be made. You figure if that's the progression of life, you should see at least somewhat as many dead people as you see new people. Why don't I see dead? If you came up to me and said you want to see a picture of a dead guy, I'd go, yeah, I would. I only see the baby pictures. Ew. You know, you see a picture of a dead guy, it's okay to go, ew. Can't do that with a baby picture. Ooh, what happened to his head? But a dead guy, that's fine. It's far more interesting. Babies are like poems. They're beautiful to their creator. But to other people, they're silly and they're fucking irritating. Keep the picture in your wallet. Every time you say you hate kids, people always say the same thing. It would be different if it was your own child. Oh, yeah? Well, what if it wasn't? Yeah. What if I believed all of you people who told me that, and on your good word, I squeeze out a rat of my own, and I end up hating my own flesh and blood just as much as I hate the screaming piece of shit on the airplane next to me, or that filthy fuck in the Denny's booth behind you who climbs over and he plays in your hair, and he drools chewed up pancakes down the back of your neck, and his parents think it's hilarious, and you're hungover and you want to fucking... not hurt the kid or anything, but maybe squeeze a lemon in his eye. Something that's not traceable back to me. If it was my own kid, I could do that to him all day long. I don't know that would ever get boring to me. How do you know what kind of a parent you're going to be ahead of time? How do you know that you're not going to end up being that one shake-the-baby parent? The people who snap like that, they didn't see it coming ahead of time. They were as stupid as you or me, walking through life. They weren't sitting in the delivery room staring down the big hole going, get out here, you son of a bitch. I want to shake you. Come on. Push, mama. I want to shake the baby. I want to shake him till his spine goes all rattly. They fucking snap. They snap after months and months of successive nights of... Would you please just shut up for 1 second? I want to sleep for a fucking hour. Shake the baby. Shake the baby. Every time I consider having a child, I read a story in the newspaper where some parents left their kid locked in a hot car for 10 hours, and his little brain bakes like a blueberry muffin because one of them forgot it was in there. I've done shit that irresponsible in my life. You know, it was with ice cream, but how do you know? You draw the line in a kid. I don't want to take that chance. And I don't necessarily want to see the kind of child I would produce at this point in my life. That's the scariest thought. I mean, with the shit I've done to my body over the years, I've done drugs and alcohol, tobacco, the acid I've pumped into my system in my 20s as it is. I don't want to see the kind of baby my sperm is waiting to create. I mean, because you look at people who were in great condition, and even them, you watch football, right? Every other fucking guy in the National Football League is on Sunday afternoon. Hi, this is Doug Flutie for the United Way. And this is my boy Wacky. He was born without bones. And these guys are in perfect physical condition, and they're blowing out rubber heads like it's Jiffy Pop popcorn. I would have the biggest elephant man baby you would ever see in your life with the shape I'm in. And if I did have a fucking wacky circus infant like that, I couldn't be one of those devoted United Way parents who has a 10-year bedside vigil just waiting for little Waterhead to blink one time. I couldn't do it. I would leave that baby at the closest church doorstep with a note in his little flipper hand, and I would be on the first Third World Airlines flight out of this country. I couldn't be a responsible enough parent if my kid were born with a new suit and a full-time job, much less fish gills or an ingrown head of some sort. You stop fucking, you just, all those problems that you bitch about end when you stop fucking pushing them out, just for 10 years or something, till we need babies. School shootings. Got a problem with it? We'll stop fucking. There's no kid. Anyone who got fucked with even a little bit in high school, you're going to hear those stories. I'm not saying condone the story, but there's a little part of you going, that was my fucking idea. Kill all the jocks. I spent every study hall. You motherfuckers. Ha, ha, ha. Look who's giving the wedgies now, bitch. Fuck you. I want to, now it's all popular. I want to go back to my fucking high school reunion packing. What, hey, Doug, what have you been doing the last 20 years? Fucking reloading, clack, clack, boom, wah! Yeah, I've been ruminating, I've been stewing in it. Dick, clack, clack, boom, wah! I wrote jokes, you know? If you got a kid being fucked with in school, teach him to write jokes. That's what, we all the comics, we were all the funny ones. I mean, all the fucking kids that got fucked with, we're the ones who turned into, like, all the fucking frat, fucking thick-neck jocko, fucking, those guys didn't turn out to be hilarious. Hey, remember that guy Lenny who used to fucking kick your books out of your hand, call you a faggot, push you in a locker, fucking hold you down, do spit hangers over your face? Yeah, he's a ventriloquist now. They're all titty bouncers now. Keep your hands off the girls or I'll give you a severe wedgie. That's why I never go to titty bars. Like, titty bars, like, because you never, first of all, like, on the road as a comic, you never know the rules. You go all, like, every state, every county has a fucking different, like, titty bar, you know, regulations and shit. And there's always that fucking university ex-quarterback who blew out his knee and now he's just a fucking loser working the door, angry at the world. Keep your hands off the girl! I wasn't touching the girl. I was just giving her a dollar. You don't give her a dollar. You put the dollar on the stage and at the end of the song she comes over and she sweeps up the dollars with the broom. Well, across the street. Across the street's a different county. Fucking backtalk me, man. Like, how do you have, why do you have titty bar laws at all? Why is there a such thing? These are the fucking dark ages. Don't fool yourself. They're titty bar, your tits are illegal. Your tits are put in the same category as handguns. It's okay to have them locked up in the privacy of your own home, but if you whip them out in public without the proper permit, you'd go to jail just for owning your own tits in this country. You would. They fucking, two guys went to jail in Houston for butt-fucking each other in their own home. Do you know this? Are you aware of this? Do you read the paper? This, the appellate court 3 days ago upheld the ruling. Sodomy laws. Two guys were butt-fucking in their own fucking home. And there was two guys that were butt-fucking, and then there was a third guy who used to be butt-fucking one of the butt-fuckers, and he knew that the new butt-fucker was butt-fucking his butt-fuck buddy, so he called, this is true, he called the police. Do you know this? He called the police, and he said, there's a burglary going on at this address. And there kind of was. So John Law kicks in the fucking door and finds the butt fuckers butt fucking, and under some sodomy law that you laugh at, that really, that's on the book somewhere, got enforced and was upheld by the appeals court. That's, this country sucks, ladies and gentlemen. That's what I'm saying. Don't believe all the fucking patriot bullshit they blew up your ass in high school. This is a fucking nitwit, dip fuck, no separation between church and state, fucking hellhole. This might be the greatest country in the world, but that's like being the prettiest Denny's waitress. You still have a lot of work to do. Being the best doesn't necessarily make you fucking good. Separation of church and state is called the perineum, and the episiotomy didn't hold. There you go. It's all fucking gunked up together down there. Titty bar laws, you can... Generally, a titty bar law, you can have titties and beer. Or you can have a vagina and an $8 Coke. But you can't have a vagina with beer and titties. Someone tried all three at once and burst into flames. And there are big lawsuits and liability issues. And if you've ever seen a vagina up close, you need a couple of shots to take the edge off of that. Looks like fucking alien's gonna spring out of there and attach itself to your face and lay eggs in your mouth. Get it off me, Danny! Kick it! Ow! Oh, help me! It's your vagina! How do you regulate tits? What fucking guy did you put in office That way all the first thing is we gotta legislate them titties. They're running amok them breastises. Keep them away from the children. They're made for children. Your tits are illegal, and that's the only reason anyone wants to see them. When you think about it, the tit is the most beautifully marketed product in this country. You will jump through a flaming hoop just to look at a tit, and it's because you can't. How much money do you think a titty bar in one of those National Geographic African villages is going to make on a Saturday night? Think they get a $10 cover charge at the door over there? Come on in and look at some tits. Fuck you, I look at her tits. She's just going home with grain on her head. It's the way it should be. I think if women were forced to wear gloves, then we only want to look at your hands, because we can't. Fucking look at the mitts on that girl. Show her, baby, yeah! Show some callus to daddy. Woo! Oh, that's a fucking real hand there. It's not even... Hand job would be the ultimate sexual act. You hold out for the hand job. She wouldn't give up the hand, man. No, she fucking palm teased me till like 3:30 in the morning. Made me read her poems. If women can walk around with no shirts like guys do, I might stare for a day or something. But after that, you don't give a shit. And I know that because I've sat in a titty bar for so long, you become completely desensitized. You spend 8 hours with tits hanging in your face and slapping off your head. Whatever, just get me another cocktail. But if that cocktail waitress leans over and you can see down her shirt, you go, look, you can see her tit. It's right there. Check it out, man. After 8 hours, that's the best tit you saw all night. Because that's the tit you're not supposed to see. All I'm saying, ladies, you want us to stop staring at your tits? Take off your shirts. And I will buy you a cocktail. All of those laws are bullshit. How do you have any vice law? It's a fucking vice. Are there any vice cops in here? Because I know you wouldn't fucking admit it, but one day you'll be in here and I want you to know you're a fucking dick. You should have the worst kind of ass cancer that an angry god can create. Like, the ass cancer that physically hangs out of the back of your pants, like a big pink fleshy beehive hanging out of the back of your boxer shorts that your kids poke at with a stick when you go to the toilet in the morning. And they go, that's daddy's ass cancer. That God gave that to him. For being a fucking cock. How do you do that for a living? You bust people... Arrest me. Have you been fucking arrested? Like, it's fucking rape is what it is. For having a bad habit. That's what a vice is. They got fucking vice cops busting smokers in California now, you know? Because they made it illegal to smoke in bars and restaurants because of waitresses. That's how they do it. They'll do it here, too. They did it in Austin. They fucking do it. Anchorage passed no smoking in restaurants. Fucking Anchorage. That's like my place to fucking... No law gets passed in Anchorage. They don't have any laws. Because waitresses are evidently dying by the thousands from the secondhand smoke. There's big Phnom Penh killing fields of fucking dead waitresses. Can't produce a body. The tobacco industry has mass graves somewhere. They'll find them eventually. If secondhand smoke, and answer me, if you have an answer, I want to hear it. If secondhand smoke is killing that many people, if anybody, and nicotine is the most addictive substance on the planet, why is no one addicted to secondhand smoke? If you're dying from it, you must have been addicted to it years before. Do you know secondhand smokers? Do you know people who get laid or get in a stressful situation and have to run out to a fucking bingo hall or an AA meeting to start breathing deeply? No, because someone is bullshitting you in the propaganda mill. They get fucking vice cops going into bars, busting smokers. Dress up like a smoker tonight, Bob. We're going in undercover. In California, they do. Fucking some crime stopper calls a fucking 800 number and then the fucking... Someone smoking in the bar. I walk past it. I don't go to bars, but I saw it, so you better go out there and enforce that. And you read these stories, and you go, don't you have a fucking real crime to fight? And then you think about it, a vice cop doesn't fight real crime. A real cop fights real crime. A vice cop's only job is to fuck up the party. That's all he's hired to do. He's a church cop. He's there to bust you for smoking dope or goes to titty bars. Make sure you're not, make sure there's not too much ass crack showing. He goes to smut shops. Make sure you're not jacking off in a jack-off booth. Ooh, you're a hero. Every vice is a punishment in itself. You smoke cigarettes, you get cancer, you die. You don't need a ticket on top of it. The punishment is inherent in the act. You watch too much porno. It diminishes your taste for the kind of girls who will actually fuck you. It's got a downside. They all do. I've done them all. I've done drugs till I've done coke till my nose was bleeding like the fourth week of Lilith Fair. I didn't have to have someone tell me it was wrong afterwards. I figured it out. I've had hookers before. I've had 6 or 8 hookers in my life. I never woke up the next day going, man, I'm glad I got a hooker last night, huh? Who's the thinker, Bobby? You go, I could have jerked off and saved $185. What was I thinking? I'm never drinking again. Now I gotta check my dick for spots for the next 6 months. To go to jail on top of that, that's double jeopardy. That's unconstitutional. Tell me one reason prostitution should be illegal. Seriously. One fucking reason if it's not a fucking church issue. There's no reason. Why is it? It's perfectly okay for a guy to go to a bar. You can go to a nightclub and bullshit chicks to last call, tell you any fucked up story he can think of just so he can poon you and never call you again, leave you crying by a telephone that will never ring, heartbroken, and that's just par for the course. That's just the American way. But a guy who just really needs a blowjob meets a girl who just really needs $40. You'd think perfect couple. Nope, someone's going to the pokey tonight. Because there's a vice cop out there. I'm a vice cop and I sleep good at night knowing that nobody's comfortably high and getting a reasonably priced piece of ass on my shift. Yeah, buddy. I can't make everybody as miserable as myself, but if I could just make a dent in the community, cheese a few people off, I know I... If God had intended women to be able to prostitute themselves, he would have given them a free will and a pussy. Fucking Bible, that's an idea you'd believe if you'd never heard of the Bible or anything. You just stumbled across it in a used bookstore at a fucking adult age. Yeah, you'd buy that wholeheartedly. You didn't need that kicked into your head for thousands of years under fucking threats and false pretenses. You'd have picked right up on it. Oh, this sounds completely logical. I'm going to tell my friends. Yeah. Fucking threats is all it is. It's the only fucking thing it is. It's threats and childhood. You fucking threaten a child, they'll believe it. You fucking switch the threat of lumps of coal in your stocking with an eternity in a fiery burning hell, well, you still believe in Santa Claus too, because you're fucking threatened as a child, and if no one ever fucking tells you otherwise, why not? I feel sorry for you because you don't have Jesus in your life. I feel sorry for you. You're 45 years old and you still have a boogeyman under the bed. Get real, Francis. Come on, fucking think for yourself. It's got good points, but it's a fucking Aesop fable, you know? You take the fucking moral and you don't buy the fucking hoopla, you fucking stooge. Here's another fucking big chunk of shit in the propaganda bills. Fucking DUI, 0.08, huh? How do you feel about that? You guys, you're drunk. If you're blowing a 0.08, you're probably sloppy drunk, huh? No, you're fucking not, because you're an adult. Maybe one of you is, and we have to fucking live like dickheads because that one fucking nitwit sorority girl who's 80 pounds and anorexic sniffs a shot of Jägermeister and fucks half the football team. So we're all drunk at .08. No, we're not. But the federal government blackmails the states and says you have to make it .08. See, here's the thing. If you have a picture of a dead kid, you can get any law you want passed. You bring a fucking picture of a dead kid to Congress, and you go, it's the most obscure death in the world. fucking jet ski, this fucking T-1000 brand jet ski, if it's got a fucking three-sided widget bolt underneath it, and that's a fucking weird kind of widget bolt that if it's being dragged on this kind of trailer at 80 miles an hour and it's 30 degrees out and gravel kicks up underneath the trailer, it can whack that widget bolt right out of, and it'll fling off and careen into oncoming traffic. And it did that and went through the windshield and it fucking stuck Timmy in the head and he died with a widget bolt in his head. So now the parents are crying on 60 Minutes getting fucking widget bolt legislation. Ooh, they should have done widget bolt testing. There's no need for this. Our boy died. And they bring dead Timmy's picture to fucking Capitol Hill with a wreath around it and candles burning. And then, like, they shut down all of jet ski production in all of North America until widget bolt testing can be done in a fucking controlled atmosphere. Steve, you really passed that law? I couldn't help it. She had the dead kid's picture right there. The wreath and candles. Oh, yes, she pulled the trump card, the dead kid's picture. Mothers Against Drunk Drivers, they do. Oh, 0.08. Well, if you don't do that, we're taking away your highway funds. Well, all right. Same with this 55-mile-an-hour speed limit. Fucking, you had to do it. 0.0 dick is fucking legally drunk. It's an individual thing. A DUI, I would rather be behind you, the fucking thick-neck lumberjack, blowing a 0.17, than I would want to be behind the fucking stone-sober 300-year-old Civil War veteran. He hasn't had a drink since 19 fucking Prohibition. I don't want to be behind... You know what? I've been drinking all night. Can you tell? Look, I can do this. See? I hear a car horn over there. I can whip my neck like that. Yeah. Oh, what was that? What was that? I don't know. What was? I don't have to go... What ear did I hear it out of? I'm not... They're both mechanical. I don't know. Put the old cocksucker next to me on the side of the road and have him do the DUI test on his, you know, one leg with his artificial hip and his eyes closed, touching his nose. When he falls and smashes his pelvis, well, we both drive home scot-free. How about that? It's a fucking individual thing. I watched that guy. If it's based just on reflexes, I watched that guy. He couldn't get his coffee to his lips at breakfast and got right behind the wheel, shaking like a fucking... I should be able to take a DUI test where if I can pass my driving test at 0.16, I get a driver's license that says I'm okay to drive up until 0.16. Just like corrective lenses. It's an individual thing. You can't... The individual in this society is completely fucked. You're judged, you're put in a little fucking group, and you're judged by the fucking drunk sorority girl. We're all drunk, because she's a fucking nitwit. You know, the one person. It's like the same way we board airplanes, you know, put... Okay, we're gonna board the airplane. Let's get all the fucking slowest, encumbered, broken people with all the kids and put them first. And let all you fucking healthy, fast people go as slow as the slowest link in the group. Does it make sense? No. But you can't say no to the fucking dead kid's picture, and you can't say no to the fucking old people with the broken hips and the fucking 19 kids. If I'm wrong, you don't have to agree with me on everything. But if you don't agree with me, don't get all cheesed off, because eventually I'm going to have the fucking idea that only you and I have, and everyone else is going to be staring at us. Yeah, oh, wrap it up? Is that what you're saying? Oh, yeah, I'm starting to feel it, yeah. I dosed tonight for the first time in a long time. Starting to kick. Mind your business. The individual is it's the same with age of consent. Age of consent, yeah. Hate to tell you, but if you watch some daytime TV, you'll know this 16-year-old girl's plenty ready to start fucking. Yeah. They're out there. And on the same note, there's 35-year-old women who should have their holes puttied shut like Barbie parts. You can't say a certain age is ready to fuck. I'm just mention, I say women because that's what the law is made to protect. But, yeah, you can't tell me 18 years. I like my ladies a little on the brown side of ripe, but I think we've covered that. That's the way I prefer a little fucking intelligence to... I'll take a fucking sloppier tit and a little more fucking thinking there. But that's just me. Everyone's different. I'm not a... Oh, thanks. You gotta bring something to the... Fucking sucks getting old, man. They should raise the drinking age to, like, fucking 60, so you'd have something to look forward to, right? I'm 34. I've done everything. I fucked a midget once. What else can I do? I did. I really did. What else do you get to fucking look forward to it? How am I going to top myself? Okay. All right. That's one way. All right. I don't know. It stops you. You're no midget, though. I'd fuck you and still tell a midget story the next day, but no one would listen. That's the problem. It's been almost 9 years since I fucked a midget, and it's never come up once. I only fucked a midget so I could say I did. It's never come up once on its own organically. It's a tough one to wean into conversation, you know? See that Super Bowl? Yeah, and I fucked a midget once too, like 9 years ago. What? I had an opportunity after a show. How could you not fuck a midget one time just to say I fucked it? Live your own lives then, because I like to wake up with a story. This is a true story. And I fucked a midget, and I did a bit about it on my first CD, Sicko. And since then, I have two midget friends up in Alaska, Kenny and Dave. They're guys that hang out at this bar I work in Alaska. And I'm talking to them when I just met them. I'm talking to them, and I go, you know, I do a bit about fucking a midget. And they go, hey, that's kind of offensive. Which at first I thought it was because I used the word fuck. Like the language was offensive. But I think it's far creepier to say I made love to a midget. That doesn't sound right in any sentence, right? But evidently the words midget and dwarf are huge slurs in the midget community. Do you know that? They're highly offensive. Both, do you know what they want to be called? Little people, yeah. I'm a little person. I'm 5'7". That's pretty little. I don't want to be lumped in with midgets, right? I mean, I'll call you whatever you want to be called. I don't want to offend anybody. That's not what I'm up here to do. Make up your own fucking title. I'll call you trial size or something. I don't care, but I mean, make it unique and specific. Little person is just way too vague. That's like copyright infringement on my... Kenny the Midget, this is true. Kenny the Midget says this to me. He goes, you know, he doesn't really talk like this, but fucking comedic effect, right? He goes, you know, calling a midget, that's like calling a black guy a nigger. Oh, yeah, that's exactly the same, Kenny, yeah. Oh, certainly, because of all the years of midget oppression, right? Right, oh, the midget-only water coolers, I remember, yeah. The little tiny booster seats in the back of the bus, yeah, certainly. Every time I see a white cross by the side of the road, I thought that was a highway fatality. But no, that's where the Klan ran a midget family out of town, evidently. Wait, it gets better. It gets better. This is how he follows it up. He goes, and by the way, I'm not a midget. I'm a dwarf. After he tells me how horrible both of those words are, how offensive both of those words are, he explains the physical differences between the two. That a midget is proportionate to a regular person, only smaller. And the dwarf is the wacky kind with the big wobbly head and the nubby little arms that's hilarious to look at. And I go, fuck you, Kenny, if there's technical differences, it's not a word of hate. If there's physiological characteristics associated with the terms midget and dwarf, it's nothing like calling a black person. You'd never call a black guy a nigger, have him get done kicking the shit out of you, and on his way out, stop and say, oh, and by the way, technically I'm not a nigger, I'm a spook. Because a nigger has a wider jaw and a more protruding buttock. He stands about 4 inches taller on the average, but thank you very much for asking. That's how fucking bored this generation is. These fucking midgets are angry. Everyone's fucking angry. Everyone's gonna cause, and they're bullshit. They take what used to be like good liberalism. They've taken and blown it so tits out that you root against it just on cause. You know how you fucking hate the Cowboys just because Cowboy fans are dicks? That's what liberalism. I'm just using that as an example, but that's what, fucking PETA, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. I would never hurt an animal. That's fucked up. But they're so fucking tits gone with the whole thing. They're out trying to get lobsters the right to vote or some weird shit. And you listen to an hour of them and you go, "That's so, I want to choke a fuzzy bunny right in front of you because you're a fucking nitwit." Now I'm rooting against what I would be for normally because you're a fucking nitwit. They had the gut beer. You remember that? They were on college campuses promoting beer drinking so you don't drink milk, because we shouldn't drink milk. Humans are the only species who drink milk after they've been weaned from the breast. Duh. You know why animals don't drink milk after they've been weaned from the breast? They're out of milk. They can't get any more. Same reason they don't smoke cigarettes. They're fucking out. I think an animal doesn't want to drink milk after being weaned from the breast. Eat a bowl of cereal in front of your cat. He'll dry hump your sock crusty just to lick the spoon. And so you listen to an hour of that fucking nitwit shit, and don't wear fur. We're going to blockade the entire avenue that you go to work on at 9 a.m. to say don't wear fur. Well, I wasn't going to wear fur. What do I look like, fucking Liberace? But now I've waited for 3 hours in traffic because you fucking cemented yourself to the fucking highway like some fucking weird Christ figure. Now I'm going to wear the first furry fucking thing that walks past me, dick. Meow. There you go. Happy? Happy dick. Fucking starting to kick. Yeah. Yeah, it's gonna be a fucking long afternoon tomorrow. Do you do drugs at all? Huh? Acid I haven't done for a while up until about 40 minutes ago, man. So you thought you might like to go to the show. Yeah, it's going to be a long night. Mushrooms are the only drug that I still really consider, and except for times of fucking stress and disorganization such as tonight. Because mushrooms are easy on you. Fucking acid beats the shit out of your body. Believe me, I'll be paying for this for a while. Because that's a three-day hangover. I don't have that kind of time anymore. I wish I had 3 days I could sit on a couch and recover, but you get older, you got shit to do. That's why every time you hear in the press, more and more high school kids are doing drugs. Who better to do drugs than high school kids? What are you gonna fuck up that bad when you're 17 that you can't bounce right back from? Your test? Who gives a shit? You're not gonna forget your kids at daycare and blow all your rent money, shake the baby. Great. Suspend me. I fucked this skanky chick without a condom last night, and I woke up this morning right at the head of my dick is an F. Alright. I fucking put all my life savings on 17 Black because I was drunk, because fucking John kept saying, do another shot, and I did. And I put all my money on 17 Black and I got detention. Fair enough. Good night. It's fucking Friday late show. People gotta go home. I'll just assume they're not offended by my fucking antics. But I'll do a tit fuck joke in the meantime. Here. Hey, so I told my girlfriend I wanted to fuck her between the tits. She said, "How you gonna make that feel good for me?" I said, "Right before I come, I'll stop punching you in the face." Right? There's no artistic merit to that joke whatsoever, but it's a little... It's like I use that like a lifeline. You know, I get stumped. I don't know where I'm going. fucking jug starts straightening the spine, and you're going, oh man, I haven't done this in 10 years. I'm glad you're part of it, even though you think I'm fucking kidding. Fucking acid is a nice, I never had a bad trip on acid. Ecstasy, I had a bad trip on ecstasy one time. Ecstasy's not a good drug to do alone, either. I found that out the hard way. Have you done ecstasy? The first time I worked Anchorage was the first time I worked. I did ecstasy, and I was working there on my birthday. Someone gave this to me as a birthday present. He said, try this. I said, what is it? They said, well, Doug, it's illegal. So I did it. They go, yeah, and it'll make you really horny. Would you rotten son of a bitch? Would you do that to me? I got horny down pat, man. I don't need narcotics to enhance it. I got horny, right? And this is my birthday present. Thank you. You would have bought Anne Frank a drum set, you psychotic. This is the last thing in the world I need. It's Alaska. It's like eight guys to every woman as it is. No one will fucking even talk to me. I did shit to myself that night I have never done to a woman. I'm not kidding. The maid came in the next morning. My whole room is soaked down in cooking oil. There's a porno going. There's a melon with a hole drilled in it. What do you use that for? I had a little luau. I just can't take the beating anymore, man. And I have my birthday is actually Sunday. Like every year on my birthday, I get all these weird presents. Since like I get all like smut shop gifts, like fucking gag gifts. I get like a blow up sheep and a fucking penis pump. All these goof gifts, which I laugh. But there's only so long shit like that can hang around your apartment before you have to stick your dick in it. I'm sorry. It's kind of like the cat or the VCR. Fucking taunting you every day. Like. But, so this last one was, 2 years ago, actually, is it just hit that wall where I can talk about it and it's not embarrassing anymore. I got a big rubber fuckhead. Have you been to smut shops? Have you ever seen like the... It's a blowjob machine. It's called a fuck my face. It's like a rubber fuck my face. And it looks like the... You know the mannequin heads, the styrofoam ones that they put wigs on in the fucking 70s? It looked like that. No features or anything. But it had the open mouth. And the mouth like it goes in and then kind of curves up and comes out the back. Like a Kennedy hole in the back. It's fucking... And you put a vibrating egg. They have, you know, the vibrating eggs they have on a lot of smut toys. It's an egg that vibrates on a cord. You can, to make it realistic. That's what it says on the box. A realistic vibrating rubber fuck my face, like vibrating, like a real vibrating blowjob. If you have a fucking epileptic fantasy or something, you're into some rape thing where you want to pretend you're scared shitless. You just crank it up real high. I don't know. It says it on the box. But okay, so here's what happens. As they get in, you can fill it with warm water and all sorts of shit. This is a fucking like high dollar item. This is a fucking they love me. Tim Mitchell is the guy who gave it to me. So anyway, so I go home, I'm drunk, it's my birthday, still no one will fuck me, so it's just me and the rubber fuckhead. And I go back to my hotel room. And I look at it, and it looks at me, and I put on something comfy, it turns on porn. So I go, I'm going to fuck the rubber fuckhead. And my dick wouldn't fit in it. And it's not my dick. A lot of you have seen it. It's a fucking manufacturing flaw. I have a little dick, but it, like the mouth is like a fucking bottleneck or something. And I'm like, and I'm not like hard like as a rock. I'm not like turgid in anticipation of the rubber fuckhead. It's not like I was like fucking had a Woody all the way home. I can't wait to fuck it. So I'm trying to have to squeeze blood into it and try to fucking like thread the head in there. Hope I get hard while I'm already in it. Or, like, I wanted to fuck the thing. It's a top shelf item. This is a high dollar. This isn't just like a bag of gook you jack off and for fucking 9 1/4. This is a top shelf rubber vibrating hot water fuck my face. And I'm trying to like corkscrew it on. It's got the little teeth apparatus on the inside, like little like rubber nubby things on the throat part where it goes in. Like which hurt. Like, I'd get my dick in there and get it semi-hard and then fucking start to hurt and spin my dick back out all purple. Like, if there's one thing that you could expect from an artificial blowjob, no teeth would be the one benefit. But no, someone in some weird factory had to put teeth things in there. Some bitter fuck like myself. They put teeth into an artificial rubber. Fuck my face. This will show them. So, like 90 minutes goes by, I'm trying to fuck this thing, and you start jacking off in weird ways like that, you get committed. Like, what do? You spend fucking all night jacking off in a rubber fuck my face to no avail. What do there? Exactly. You chuck the rubber fuck head to the side, and you jack off the old-fashioned way with the vibrating egg in your ass. That's what I thought, too. I didn't see. It's my birthday. Fuck you. I don't see where it's going to be a problem. And it wasn't great. It wasn't bad. All right? It's a little numby, a little tingly in the old sphincter. It didn't fucking... Nobody got killed, but it didn't raise the bar on jacking off where I need a vibrating egg in my ass to get there. But it definitely... It fucking had its highs and lows, and I get done, you know? And this is what happened. This is what Tim Mitchell, the guy who gave me the rubber hot water vibrating fuck my face, comes back over to my room 2-3 hours later, whatever. And I'm done, you know? You feel dirty, but that goes away. And he sits down. Listen to me. He sits down on the bed, and he's talking about the weather or fucking the game or small talk, and just very casually, he says, "What's that?" There's a small piece, a chunk of fucking paraphernalia, some doodad on the bed, and very casually, he flicks it with his finger, and he goes, "What's that?" And it goes, and it sticks to the wall. Yeah, it was poop, ladies and gentlemen. It was fucking poop. Evidently, when I pulled that vibrating egg out of my ass, a small dollop of poop chased after it like a needy child. And now it's sitting there all alone at the foot of my bed and now splatter against the wall. And it's all over Tim Mitchell's finger. And he wants an answer, believe me. It's shit, man. It fucking shit on my finger, dude. I got nothing. I'm pretty good on an excuse if you would ask me to help you move tomorrow. I could come up with something. I can't. I have spinal surgery at 9 a.m. I'd come up with something. I got nothing for fucking shit all over. So I go, I don't know. Like, maybe that's just how I party. I'm fucking terrified of poop. My fear of poop is an equal line with my love of pooning a girl in the ass. It's a double-edged sword. What do? Is it fear of poop? Are you pooning a girl? Yeah. Huh? Say she's going to let you poon her in the ass tonight. Huh? Chuckles. Look at me. Because she doesn't take in the ass yet. You know, at one point she will. But right now, no. Yes, no. 6 years, she's taking in the ass. But say tonight she's inspired. She goes, that comic made me really want to take in the fucking the corn shoot. Let's say she does, and that's a good night for any of us, right? But say you get that first exploratory Ernest Shackleton probe finger in there, and you're immediately greeted by the angry nose of yesterday's BK broiler, just sitting in there like a guard dog waiting for you. What do you do, smart ass? You know all the answers. Tell me, do you open up a line of communication? Do you talk it through with her? Do you try to push it back up and you just start to cry and run out of the building? There's got to be some protocol, and I don't know what it is. I've written a fucking Hints from Heloise 2 times, and nothing ever comes back in the return mail. Are you having fun over there? The poor guy behind the fucking pole. I don't know. Pornography ruins you. What is that fucking thumping in the fucking... Is that just me? Do you hear the thumping in the... Every now and then. In the micro... All right. Maybe... I know that's not just me tripping. All right. Please hold. I got to look at my watch in a fucking show of unprofessionalism. But I feel you getting tired. No. All right. I feel me having a piss. How about that? I can bring it down to an honest level, right? Wow. I get a lot of fans at that table that wanted to be in line to meet me after the show. proceeded early. Maybe. My act's not for everyone. What can I say? Go to another place. If this is what you expect. How many people came here to see me, Doug Stanhope, specifically tonight? All right, how many people came to see whatever bag of shit was standing behind the microphone? There you go. See? If you don't like me, it's your own fucking fault. This is the only form of entertainment where people do that. They show up. It's comedy. You don't show up for drama or horror or comedy. Would just show. There it is again. What is that, man? Oh, it's pussy snapping. There you go. That's fucking fine. There you go. Brian Hersey. Brian Hersey's gonna get 90 seconds of comedy tonight. I forgot completely what I was talking about. Oh, comedy, yeah. You don't go to concerts and you want to go to a concert tonight? Who's playing? I don't have any earthly idea. We'll just show up at the stadium and be potluck. You don't go to fucking movies, tickets to whatever's closest. I don't care. I'm lazy. I'm just trick hip. And comedy, you just show up, you know? Which works out well for me. You don't like me? Fuck off, huh? Go to a video, go to rent porno, just grab any books off the shelf. Don't get pissed off. There's two guys taking bumps on one another's chests. There's lots of different kinds of porno, and there's lots of different kinds of comedy. You don't like it? Fucking read the books next time, dick. Ladies and gentlemen, there comes a time at every comic where he has to bring up a local guy from out of the fucking blue and do 90 seconds of comedy. Brian Hersey. Where's Hersey? Where are you, Hersey? He fucking had. No, he said doing it. He's gonna do it because he fucking heckled me and it was funny. Now he's gonna fucking show his wares while I piss and he's gonna do 90 seconds of fucking unwanted comedy to a fucking riotous crowd. A riotous crowd, he said. Hersey, 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 Hersey. You fucking knew it. I'll do this joke in the meantime. I have a bit of a potty mouth. My dad used to wash out my mouth with soap, but it was just to get rid of any traces of his DNA. Now, remember? When we were Hersey, 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 Hersey. Oh, he's coming down the hallway like a boxer. He's got the fucking two guys on each side. Hersey is. Ba-dum, 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 ba-dum. So, yeah, thought ya.
Too fucked up to be up here right now. I don't know if anybody knows, but I'm an actual comic. And I really should not be on stage at this point in the evening. Doug's getting paid, so he's fairly sober. I am seriously fucked up. I should not be up here. It's your people's fault. Alright, we'll try. Let's see if I can go through a bit here. How many people have seen me before? Anybody? Nobody? Few people. All right. Well, let me. You'll know if I fuck up them. I got a speeding ticket recently, and just between us, I'm not slowing down. I don't think anybody else here should. Don't slow down. When you get a speeding ticket, that's not a crime. All right. That's a form of random taxation. That's all that shit is. Right. It's not a crime if you can get out of it by taking a class. That's how I know it's not a crime. Right. Theft, rape, murder. Those are real crimes. You can't take a class for that shit. You can't go. Up for defensive homicide class, can you? Some balls up there for 6 hours. All right, class, what do you do when the cops find you standing over a dead body with a bloody knife? You have a chainsaw. Would you like to answer that? I tell them, don't look at me. I just got here myself. Good answer. Good answer. Domestic violence. Welcome to domestic violence class. What's your name and why are you here? My name is Carl. I'm here because I beat the shit out of my wife in a school zone. The fines are doubled. Fuck it, I'll take the class. School zones. I mentioned something. School zones, we gotta get rid of school zones, right? I don't get the concept. Slowing down just because a few kids are around? Why? So they can get a good shot? Is that why we're slowing down? We got 12-year-olds doing drugs, having sex, and killing people. I think they can learn to cross the street with the rest of us. Ladies and gentlemen, Doug Stanhope!
Hersey! Whole fucking criminal mentality, like that whole bullshit. Fuck you, do the crime, you better be able to do the time. That whole fucking burn the fucking kill of fry them. That mentality is gonna fucking kill, man. It does, it's fucked up. That's. Because it's that fucking same kill all the fucking the death row guy, George Bush fucking nitwit fry mentality. It's, you read the boys 18 years every fucking week now. 18 years, 17 years in prison. Fucking guys who did nothing. DNA testing that you didn't want to give them. Because that'll fuck up your story. You don't want to give them. They get the DNA testing and they're out. And you know what? They say, hey, have a nice day, man. 18 fucking years of our life. That's. Take it easy here. We'll reimburse you the $5,000 that you had when you were a janitor when we fucked you in the first place. We can afford to do that because if you had any money, we wouldn't have railroaded you like to begin with. I say if you did the time, you had to do the crime. How about that? Spin it back around. These motherfuckers walking out 18 years. Yeah. Well, you get a gift certificate right there. Yeah, remember me, lady? Remember when you said the black guy did it? Black guy's knocking at your fucking door and he's got 18 inches of cotton tear off in your ass. And if I come too quick, don't worry. I can make up the other guys on a gift certificate. I'll kick your dog on the way out for a fucking year. I'll do 6 months for fucking taking your toaster. Yeah. That fucking whole. Fucking kid that's 12 years old. He's fucking a 12 year old fat kid. Fucking life in prison. Oh yeah, we're gonna treat these kids like adults. You know what I'm talking about? The wrestling move. He's doing the wrestling move on the girl. Killed her. All right, yeah, he do something. But in the paper, they actually said that he was only 12 years old, but he was already 120 pounds. They actually said, as though that might justify. Well, he weighed as much as an adult. Try him as such. Listening still, right? Hopefully George Bush can fuck up this country so much that people actually do something. Because no one in this country does it until your fucking nose is pushed in it. You're the only one laughing anymore, and it's goading me. All people are staring. Go back to the things out of your ass stuff. All right, I'm going shortly. I just need one more beer and Jägermeister to the fucking head. This neck thing. Alright. Here's the keys to life. Because I have them. Big key to life, excess in moderation. They'll tell you moderation is the key to life, and that's half the story. You have to stretch it out every now and then, right? Don't eat, don't drink a couple of beers every night after work. Pick one night of the week, like tonight, and drink all the fucking beers at once. It's completely shit. Find your range. Find the outside wall. Right? This is Mark Babbitt, the manager of the place. He's not the owner. He's the manager. Here's to you guys. I'm sorry. Drink and do other things too much. Right before I quit smoking, I had a friend of mine read me the Riot Act. Do you know what you're doing to yourself? I mean, for God's sakes, you smoke almost 3 packs of cigarettes a day, and you're drunk on stage every night. You're just destroying your body. I said, don't you have 4 children? I'm destroying my body? I can put my hand in your cunt and still flip. coin, but I'm destroying my body. Might be a little greedy in the liver, but I don't have to carry my tits in my pants pockets. Here's to you guys. You've been a great crowd. Thanks for tolerating.